One day, while the Buddha was residing at the Chaitawana Monastery, he gave a very moving sermon. A young man who happened to be in attendance was riveted. He felt thoroughly invigorated and wished to ordain. He quickly went home to his wife and asked for her permission. She was reluctant, but had no way to stop him. So, she gave her permission. The man ordained and focused on his mental cultivation. However, he was not able to obtain the fruit of the Dhamma. The monk's former wife, feeling lonely and abandoned, wished for the monk to renounce his vows and return home. She dressed provocatively and brought food and fruit that she knew would please the monk. She shared her struggles and told him how much she missed him. After she left, the monk could not focus. His thoughts wandered. He wondered how his wife was doing, if she was thinking about him, and if she could survive without him. He wondered when he would get to see her again, and how it would feel to just touch her one more time. He knew all these thoughts were harmful to his holy life, and that they would pull him away from the path he knew he wanted to travel. However, the strength of his desire, resulting from his spiritual immaturity, weighed heavily upon him. The monk went to see the Buddha, intending to ask for permission to disrobe. The Buddha asked him,
"Monk, is it true? Is it true that you are overtaken by passion and desire? Is your heart filled with longing and regret?"
The monk responded,
"My lord, I cannot stop thinking about my former wife. I think about her all the time and can't get her out of my mind. I don't know what to do other than disrobe and go be with her."
The Buddha said,
"Monk, this woman is harmful for you. It was because of her that in the past you almost met your end."
The monk begged the Buddha to make clear the past that was blocked from his memory due to countless rebirths. The Buddha proceeded to remind him of his past as he recounted this story. Once upon a time, when Brahmadatta was reigning in Benares, the Bodhisat was his family's priest. In the main river that flowed past the city, there was a large fish that was infatuated with his fish wife. He swam circles around her and did not pay attention to anything around him. All his eyes could see was his fish wife. Now, in those days, fishermen would cast large nets into the river, hoping to catch fish to sell at the market. The female fish saw the net and swam around it. However, the male fish, not paying attention to anything other than the female fish, swam right into the net and was caught. Hoping to keep the fish fresh, the fisherman did not kill him, but instead flung him onto the sand. There, the fish flopped and lamented out loud,
"Oh, I do not fear the embers of death. But alas, what I fear most is that my wife will think I have left her for another."
Just then, the king's family priest happened to walk by, hoping to bathe in the river. The Bodhisat priest had the ability to understand the language of animals. Therefore, he understood what the fish was saying. The Bodhisat thought, if this fish dies in this state of passion and lust, he will definitely be reborn in hell, in an undesirable state. I must try to save him. The priest went up to the fisherman and said, would you be willing to donate one of your fish to our curry?
Of course. Pick any fish that you desire.
I would like that fish over there, please.
Then that fish is yours, sir.
The Bodhisat took the fish gently in his two hands and spoke to it, saying,
my friend, if I had not seen you today, you would have met your death. Control your passions and desires. Those who are slave to desires will suffer and die because of them.
And with that, he threw the fish back into the water and went back into the city. And the Buddha ended the lesson, saying, as you can see, in the past, you were the fish that I saved. Your former wife was that female fish that you were obsessed with, and that obsession almost led you to your death. Will you once again follow your passions and meet your doom, or will you allow me to help you?
The young monk understood the Buddha's teachings and gained clarity. The Buddha, seeing that the young monk was ready, preached the Four Noble Truths, after which the monk gained the first level of enlightenment.
What did you learn from this story? We hope you enjoyed the video. Click like if you did. And click subscribe if you want to see our uploads.